Welcome back to this new video. Today I will explain to you how to use the activity execute macro in UiPath. This video will cover all topics about macros in UiPath. I will talk about the properties of this activity, which are the following: macro name, macro parameters, and macro output. I will also talk about sub and function in macros. What is the difference between them, and when to use each one? I will show you many different examples using different scenarios, so that you are able to use any macro you need after watching this video. If you like the video and want to see more videos about UiPath activities, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Let's go! As I did in each video, I will first talk about the activity, and then I will go ahead with the examples in UiPath. Execute macro, what does it for? It's to execute a macro in Excel. So we use it only for macros in Excel. For this activity we have these main three properties. Macro name is the name of the macro, which we want to execute. This name is defined in the Excel file, where we wrote or recorded the macro. Macro parameters, this property is to add the parameters for the macro, if we have parameters. It means, here we set the input parameter for the macro. So if we have a macro, where we defined input parameters, we can add these parameters in this property. To add the parameters you have to set them as following. We use brackets, and then we set the different parameters in the correct order. For example, I have this macro, where I have these two parameters as input. So I first set the first parameter, then the second one. This property is optional. It means, if we don't have parameters in the macro, we don't have to add anything here. The last property is the macro output. This can be used to store the result from the macro, if the macro returns a result. So not each macro has an output, therefore this property is also optional. These are the properties of execute macro activity. One last important thing about this activity is, that we cannot use this activity without Excel application scope activity. It means, we always need first Excel application scope activity, and then we can use execute macro within this Excel scope. That's all about this activity. Let's now talk about the next point, sub and function. What does each one mean and when to use it? Sub stands for subroutine. It's a part of code to perform a specific task in the code, but it doesn't return a value. It means we don't have an output from this macro type. Function is the same as sub, but it returns a value. It means we have here an output. Functions can also be used in Excel directly like any standard function of Excel, for example sum function to get the sum of different numbers from different cells. In summary, we use sub to write a macro, if we don't want to return an output. And we use function in case we want to return an output from the macro. This is the difference between the both types. There are many other differences between both, but only this point is relevant for us today. Let's now see, how does the structure of macro look like? We first set sub or function. It depends on our need, if we have an output or not. And at the end we close the macro with end sub or end function. After sub or function we set the macro name. Here we can choose a name for the macro, which we can use to call this macro. After that we add brackets. These brackets are to set the input parameter for the macro, if we have parameters. It means, if we don't have parameters for the macro, we let them empty. But if we need some parameters, we can add them within the brackets. To add a parameter we have first to set a name for the parameter. After that we write as and then the type of this parameter. For example integer, string or something else. As already mentioned, only function macro could have an output. So if we use function and we have an output, we can set it after the brackets. To do that we write as and then the type of the output. Here we can again set integer, string or something else. And the last and most important part of the macro is the body. So here we write the code, what we wanted using the macro. This is how a macro looks like. Let's see the following example to understand the structure better. Here I have at the beginning sub. After that I have the macro name, SumTwoNumbers. Then I have in brackets two parameters of type integer. And after the brackets I don't have anything, which means that we don't have an output from this macro. Now the macro code. Here I have only print method, to print out a text in the output console. So here I will print out the sum of the input parameters. At the end we have end sub, because we use sub at the beginning. That's all, what you have to know about macros. Let's now switch to UiPath to implement some examples. I will first add execute macro activity. As you see we have a compiler error, because we cannot use this activity without Excel application scope. So I will add Excel application scope. And now I will put execute macro activity within Excel application scope activity. For the scope activity, we have to enter the Excel file path. So here I have this Excel file. It's an Excel file with macros, as you see. Let's copy the path and enter it in UiPath. As you see, we have the following properties: the macro name, the parameters, and here the output. Let's create a macro in the Excel file and try to execute it in UiPath. I will navigate to Developer, and then to Visual Basic. Now I will add a module to write the macro. So I will write the macro manually, but you can also record the macro. I will write this simple macro to get a message box with a specific text. So I have sub macro, and here also the end of the macro. Here is the macro name, show message. And the code is to get the message box with this text, hello YouTube. Let's copy the macro name and add it in UiPath. Now I will save the Excel file and close it. And now I will run the code. As you see, I didn't add the parameters or the output, because I don't have any input parameters or output. Only the macro name. So I got the message box with the text, what I wrote in the macro. It works good. And the execution is finished without any errors. Now I want to use the parameters. Let's change the macro. I will add the following parameter. It's of type string. And now I want to print out the text from the parameter. So I have now a parameter. And the message box now should print out the text from this parameter. Let's save the Excel file and close it. And here I will add the parameter. So here no need to write the parameter name. You only have to write the value directly, or you can also use a variable. Let's write the value directly. For example, the following text. And now I will run the code. As you see, I got the message box, but now I have the same text, what I added as parameter. It works fine. Let's change the macro again. I will now add a new parameter for the same macro. And now I want to print out the second parameter also in the message box. So now we will get the both texts in the message box. Let's save the Excel file first. And now I will add the parameters. So here is the text for the first parameter. And here is the text for the second parameter. Let's run again to see the result. As you see, we have the first text. Then colon. Then the second text. Let's now change the macro again, to use another parameters. I will add the following parameters. Both of type integer. And in the message box I want to print out the sum of both numbers. So we have number 1 and number 2. Both of type integer. Let's save Excel again. I will now change the parameters. Now we need two integer numbers. Let's run again. As you see, we have the number 3. It's the sum of the numbers 1 and 2. This is how to use parameters for a macro. Let's now see how to use output property. I will change the macro. First, we have to use function instead of sub, because we want to get an output. And here I will set the type of the output. For example, integer. Assume I want to get the sum of the both numbers as output. Let's see how to do that. To return a value from a macro, you have to use the macro name like a variable. It means, I will use the macro name here. And for this variable I will set the calculation. This statement is like return statement in C#. In this way I should get the sum of the numbers as output. Let's save the Excel file. And now I will create a variable for the output. Here is the variable. It's always of type object. Object type is a general type, which means that the variable could be string, integer, boolean or any other type. Let's add write line activity to print out the content of this variable in the output console. As you see, we have the number 3 as result, which is the sum of the numbers 1 and 2, which I added as input parameters for the macro. It works also fine. Let's edit the macro again and add some new parameters. Now we have 5 parameters. Let's add them to the code, to check if we can use them correctly. I will change the output type to double, because the result could contain comma numbers. Let's save Excel again and switch to UiPath. Now we have to change the parameters. So we have 5 parameters, therefore we need 5 values. I will add the numbers from 1 to 5 for example. Let's run the code to check the result. As you see, we have the following number as result. It works also fine. In the examples before, I wrote the values directly as parameter. But we can also use variables. Let's for example create 5 variables for these 5 parameters. All variables should be of type integer, because the macro has the parameters of type integer. The name of the variables does not matter, you can choose any name you want. You don't need to have the same name as in the macro. And now I will use the variables as parameters instead of the values. Let's add default values for these variables. And now I will run the code. As you see, we have again the same result. It works. And now we are at the end of this video. We had different examples about macro, how to execute a macro without parameters, with parameters and with an output. This is all what you have to know, so that you can execute a macro from UiPath. The macro examples in the video were very easy, but you can use the activity to execute any macro you have. The purpose of this video was to show you how to use this activity and what you have to know about it. If you understood it, you can use it for any macro you want. I hope you enjoyed the video. This video is made on request from a follower. So if you also have a video idea, what you want to see on our channel, please don't hesitate to write us. We are here to help you as we can. If you also still have any question about this video, please write us. Have a great day and happy automation.